All right, super. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate it. And we're really grateful to have two amazing people from the Center for Excellence to present on the PTK EDGE programs and the Leadership Development Studies. So we have Dr. Johanna Williams, who is the Associate Vice President of STEM and Workforce Programs. And we also have Susan Edwards, who is the Associate Vice President of Honors Programming and Undergraduate Research. And there are no better individuals to talk about this wonderful programming that Phi Theta Kappa offers for all of our members. So I'm gonna toss it over to them and let them take it away.
Thank you so much, Mary, and hello everyone. So we're super excited to be here to talk to you about our curriculum programming. And I'm gonna talk to you today about our EDGE program and some of the courses that we have and also how you can access them and some of the benefits that you can get from taking those courses. So hopefully you can see my screen here. And I'm just gonna sort of take you on a tour through the courses and what they are, and then give you a sort of a glance at a few of them so that you'll know what to expect. But Phi Theta Kappa, PTK EDGE is our professional development curriculum. And I like to say it's personal and professional development because you develop your inner self as well as prepare for professional environments. So as you all know, for a very long time, we only had one, which was competitive EDGE. And now we have four courses and another one on the way. So all of these courses are free to our members, alumni, and advisors. And so as long as you are a member and you're logged into the PTK website just with your regular login, you have access to all of these courses. So if you're logged in, you can go to getanedge.ptk.org, or if you're already on the website, just go to members and programs and they'll all be laid out there for you. So it's several ways that you can access them, and I think they're pretty easy to find. So our four courses, just to give you a broad look at them, is Competitive EDGE, which focuses on strengthening your soft skills. Transfer EDGE prepares you to transfer to a university. Employment EDGE is all about getting a job. And then Research EDGE is all about sharpening your research skills, both internally if you're working on HIA, or generally, because you'll probably be doing more research as you progress through your academic career. So I want us to take a closer look at each one of those courses so that you'll know what to expect and also how to get to them, and then some of the benefits that you will get from taking all of those courses. I do recommend all of them before you should do all four. Because they all have different benefits that they can offer you. The first one is the one I get the most questions about, do I need it? My answer is, do you want a job? And the answer is always yes. So my answer is yes. You need Employment EDGE, whether you're a career tech or an academic student. Everybody should take a look at this one. And all of our courses are self-paced, which means you can do it in a weekend if you work the whole weekend, or you can do it in 6 months. It's entirely up to you how long it takes you to get through these courses. So the primary focus for Employment EDGE is preparing participants to enter the workforce. And the reason I said I get that question is because career tech students, of course, they're gonna enter the workforce first. So this one is definitely designed with those students in mind because they're going straight to work. But it's also a course for everyone. The rules are pretty much the same regardless of when you plan to join the workforce. So it teaches you how to achieve employment success by going through a variety of steps. So all of the courses have modules. And so this one has four, and it sort of progresses through the employment process. So for instance, the first module is just putting you on the right path to a career, making sure you know what you want to do and what major field you should be in to do that. I'm talking about getting experience with internships and things like that, just starting you off. And the second module gets to where you're doing resumes and cover letters and LinkedIn and sort of grooming your online reputation, cleaning up those Facebook and Instagram pages and things like that to really start readying yourself for employment. Making meaningful connections is advanced, and that's where networking is important. It's about what you know, but also who you know can be a really big benefit to you. So this sort of gives you a variety of ways that you can network and meet the right people. And when you meet the right people, you need to say the right thing. And so that's where personal branding is, how to sell yourself. If you happen to meet that person that might be able to give you a job in your field. Each one of the modules end with an interview with an employer where they talk about what they look for when they interview candidates. And so they give you really good tips on what you might want to say or how you might want to prepare for an interview that you might have. And then the last one tells us what to do after you get the job. Of course, the application process can be quite complicated. So we talk about that, but then after you get the job, benefits and negotiating salary and things that people really don't think about is covered in that last module. So this is sort of a glance of Employment Ed. So that's an idea of what it will look like once you log into that course. You see all of the modules are sort of spread out, has documents that you can download and take with you to go back and review. So some of it is PDF format. We have lots of videos and interviews and things like that that are included in that course. The next one is Transfer Edge. Oftentimes students think that it's easier to transfer than it is. I just leave my community college and go to the university. But it's a lot more steps involved to that than just going from one place to another. And so Transfer Edge really spells that out for you. Once again, all self-paced, you can take it at your own pace. You can take two or three at a time or one at a time. It's entirely up to you. But this one sort of focuses on preparing you to transfer. What things do I need to do before I leave the community college to be ready to go to the university? And so this one has five modules, and you can see some of the focus there. It focuses on your FAFSA if you need that, researching your transfer options. A lot of times we think we know what university we want to go to, but once we go and visit others, you get better ideas, or maybe they have a better program. So how to research and study that. Choosing schools that match your goals. If you want to major in polymorph science, for example, I'm a STEM person, so those are usually all my examples. But polymer science or engineering, they're usually universities that are great for that, that may not be your first choice. So being able to make sure that your goals match the university that you attend. Transfer applications, scholarship applications, and then that transition from community college to university. So all of those things are sort of covered in Transfer Edge. So it's highly recommended that you do that one before you start the transfer process. And this is an example, same as the other video content that you have in there. You have PDFs and documents that you can download and take with you to review later. And so as you progress through the course, you have things that you can collect and keep to help you on that progress. And then we have Competitive Edge. And this is our newer Competitive Edge where we revamped the old one. And so this one is interactive. And so the newer courses, and we're gonna update all of the older ones as well, but the newer courses, you can interact with those courses. You can click through them and play different videos, go back and forth. So these are really really engaging. And this one focuses on your soft skills. Another very common question I get is what's the difference between Employment Edge and Competitive Edge, because they both focus on jobs. But Employment Edge is more, this is how to get the job, and Competitive Edge is more, this is how you keep it. Okay? These are the soft skills you need to be successful in that job. So this one talks about personal, professional, and career success. So we have five modules in this one as well. The Think module is all about your thinking skills. So critical thinking, creative thinking, analytical thinking, it gives you lots of tips and ideas on how to develop those skills. They're really important soft skills to have. All of these skills that we got are the ones that employers said they sought after the most. And so these are definitely ones that you want to develop. The Grow one is all about growing within yourself. So self-esteem, self-confidence, assertiveness, growing your personal self so that you're ready to compete in the employment market. Connect is communication skills. And so making presentations, active listening, communicating and talking with people, networking. All of those are in the Connect module. Collaborate is working on teams. You know, you're building relationships, conflict resolution, how you work as a team, which you should be familiar with. I'm sure you all offer to teams or you're working on some team at your college. And so this enhances those skills. And then Perform is the last module there. And that one focuses on workplace professionalism. Once you get there, you're ready to perform. These are the things you'll need to know. Giving and receiving feedback, work ethic. Once again, those things that we really don't think about when we first start applying for a job that you gotta need to know once you get in the seat. So Competitive Edge covers that personal and professional development skills that you need to know. And it also has things that you can collect as you go through the course and download and review. So this one, of course, looks a little different because this is a newer one. And so it's a little bit more interactive. But this is sort of an idea of what you'll see once you log into that Competitive Edge course. Then we have Research Edge, which Susan could probably talk better about this one because she had a very hairy hand in developing our Research Edge course, but I did take it myself and very much enjoyed it. But this one is our curriculum for research. And so it teaches you the basis of academic research. It's very heavily focused on our earnest and action project and the steps that you need to go through to complete that process. It has sort of a focus, of course, on our understudy topic, which right now is the seventh generation. And so it sort of follows through that and helps you work your way through that as you develop an honors and action process. But it's very heavily focused on how to properly conduct academic research, which is really important to know, not only for HIA, but generally speaking, this is probably not the last piece of research you'll do. So you can carry a lot of this with you. So this one has an introduction and then three additional modules where it focuses on honors and action and the workbook and the rubric and how you'll be judged and how you'll design your project, academic investigation, research questions, academic sources, APA citation. Those are hugely important, especially when working on your honors in action project. So how to formulate a proper research question, how to find real academic sources, and then how to cite them properly. Research to action is our service and action. You know, you do the research and then you do an action based on what the research tells you. And so this sort of tells you how to lay that out, the service and the collaborating and working as a team. And then finally, the impact, because we do want to make a difference. You do all that work and all that writing. You want it to make a difference. And so the reflection, the impact that it made, and then of course, writing that and editing. So this one goes through all of the steps for honors in action, but once again, it's very relevant to just research in general, which you'll likely see again in the future. And this is a glance of the, this is also interactive. This is one of the interactive ones where you can click through and engage with your computer. And that's sort of an outline of what you'll see once you log into the Research Edge course. Okay, so the recognition that you get, you don't just get the benefit of taking the course, but there's also different ways that you're recognized for taking each one of the Edge courses. And you have badges, which I'll talk about a little bit more in detail next, because that's another one of the many emails I get to explain what that is and how to use it. But for every level or every module that you complete in an Edge course, you do get a badge, an electronic digital badge emailed to you. If you complete the full course, you can purchase a pin to represent that you completed the full thing. Also at Catalyst, you get ribbons that you can walk around and wear. They're usually hanging down to your knees. And so it's lots of fun stuff that you can get as you complete each one of these courses. As far as the badges are concerned, digital badges or digital credentials, they're literally like mini certificates, but they're better because they have more detail. Where a certificate might say you completed a course, the badges say what you learned in each one of those modules or what skills you've mastered. So you can display these on your LinkedIn, on your Facebook, on your all over the social media, and anybody, an employer or an application reviewer can click on it and it will specifically tell them what you mastered in that level. And it also has your name built in so they know that it's really you that earned that badge. So it's really, really more than just a pretty little badge. It really has a lot of benefit that you can use. So it's really important that you do share those, especially if you have a professional like a LinkedIn page where employers might be trying to seek you out. As you complete each one of those modules, then these badges will be emailed to you automatically. So you don't have to request them or anything. Sometimes it may be a day or two before you get them, but you will get it at the completion of each module. So you don't have to try and request those. And you get one for each one of our courses. You'll get a badge for each module in each one of the Edge courses. So some of the benefits which I've talked about before is first of all, it's personal and professional development for you. So I call it benefits, but it's really why you want to take the Edge courses. And it's because they offer a personal and professional development. It's learning extended beyond the classroom. We all know when you're in the classroom, usually you're learning what a specific skill that you'll need to do, whatever it is your goal is, but you don't really learn what how to function in the workplace or how to have self-esteem or self-confidence. That's not included in your classroom curriculum usually. So this gives you that extra thing that nobody else is getting to make sure that you're extra prepared for the opportunities that you'll run into once you finish school. It's also an opportunity to show initiative, which Employment Edge, you learn about that there, how employers like to see that. They like to see that you go beyond what's asked of you, that you put yourself out there and try and do extra. And this is one of those chances because you're PTK students and all of my students used to take 22, 23 hours. They're very busy. And then you still found the time to take an Edge course or something to give you professional growth. That looks really good. And so that's also a benefit. Of course, the digital credentials that you can display and that with the built-in information about the skills that you've mastered. It's a resume builder and it's also free. It's just free training for students and advisors and alumni. And so those are some of the reasons that it's worthwhile to take a look at these courses and participate in all of them. Once again, any order, one at a time, all at a time, you can take it in any way that you're comfortable with. And so that's my little spiel. I've been looking at my watch because sometimes I just go and go. But that if you do have additional questions, I know we have a question and answer later, but if you do have additional questions or things that you need to know about the Edge courses, that's my contact information. And you can feel free to reach out to me and I'll be glad to answer any questions that you have. And I'm going to turn it over to Susan now.
Great. Thank you, Joe. And I will tell you, although I know I'm biased because Joe is fabulous, but I'm just such a huge fan of the Edges. And I think they are collectively such a great member benefit. And it does give you the edge when you're looking for scholarships and you're looking for job opportunities and all types of things into the future, because you're going to have the skills that you've maintained with the Edges and those programs. And we have another online program, our Leadership Development Studies curriculum. Dr. Lynn Tinscher-Ladner, our president and CEO, really was ahead of the game. She didn't know the pandemic was going to hit, but she knew that we needed to have a virtual set of personal and professional development opportunities. And we've had our Leadership Development Studies curriculum for, I think we're in the 29th year now, but we're only in year two of having that online. So I'd like to talk with you about this and about the opportunities for you. Like the Edges, you have this opportunity as a member benefit for Phi Theta Kappa. So the curriculum is wholly online now, using all open sources. And the reason that that's really important is that it's free to PTK members as a member benefit. I mentioned that, but we want everyone to take the course who'd like to take the course. So the course is open to other students. And that can be community college students, university students. It can be high school students, dual enrollment students. It's $10 to access the course if you're not a member of Phi Theta Kappa. And that is a serious reduction from what the textbook, the hard copy textbook used to cost. Again, that was Dr. Tinscher-Ladner's vision and we've made it happen and we're really excited about it. And we've reached a lot of people in the last year and a half with the curriculum and we're thrilled. And we hope that if you have tried it, that you're thrilled as well. And you know, we have three certified faculty members that I can see on this call. So I'll talk a little bit about that in a minute. But here's the URL for the Leadership Studies course. You can go right on to ptk.org, click on this link, and you'll access the materials with your regular Phi Theta Kappa username and password, the one you use to get online all the time. It will work for the for the Leadership Development Studies curriculum. There are 10 units. I'm going to talk about those in a second. And it's really an inclusive group of leaders. We worked really hard to have a number of historical leaders because we were looking at open sources. I know Mary and I teach history, and so, you know, and government. So, you know, there are a lot of people we know and love here, but we also have some contemporary leaders as well, and I'll explain how we were able to do that. And then new in 2021, I'm so excited because Joe just talked about badges and how important they are, digital badges. We are going to have digital badges for every single unit, all of the 10 units in the course. And then for people who complete the entire course, there will be a separate badge as well. You can see probably the prototype on the screen. Our designer, Dionica Davis, has done the prototype. It's actually beautiful. I will tell you that the colors are even prettier when you see her mock-ups of those. She's so talented. So we're very excited about that. And they're going to be really similar to the ones for the edges where you'll be able to show scholarship, people who give scholarships or organizations that give scholarships and job opportunities to people who are giving you those, you'll be able to show them what you learned in each of the units and how you grew as a leader. So let's look at the units. We have 10 units. When you go into the course, everybody has to complete unit one, not because we're mean, but because it's a foundational unit and you have to go all the way through unit one. It's the only one where you have to do everything from reading, you know, the introduction to the course right through the unit one quiz. But it's about developing a personal leadership philosophy. And we talk about there why it's important, why it's foundational, why you should really know who you are, what you believe in, what your values are, how that has is applicable for you as a leader. And so we have a number of, I think kind of surprising things in there as you're looking at how to develop a leadership philosophy. If you look at the two women on the screen, those are the Grimke sisters, Sarah and Angelina Grimke. And just as an example of the historical figures who are part of the curriculum, they were from a plantation holding family in South Carolina. They became Quakers and really spent their lives advocating for the abolition of slavery and then advocating for women's rights. I mean, they predate the first wave of women's rights advocates in the United States. And their philosophy is really interesting. So they're two of the people we look at in the course and how they developed their philosophy, what was the background in that and why, you know, it matters for looking at leadership philosophies and what they valued. We also have some other people, John McCain and John Lewis, for example. We have both of their letters to the American people as they were facing death, and they're really amazing. And I'll talk a little bit more about what's in each unit, but just know that they're really cool people who mattered to the world, who've done incredible things and who have different viewpoints. Different, in this case, different leadership philosophies, and you get to learn about them and talk about it, and it's exciting. We also, and by the way, Chief Joseph and Frederick Douglass are the other two people, the images there, they are both in the curriculum as well, just in leading with goals and also in making decisions. So they're important. You might not think of them as the people you think of when you think, oh, you know, how do I lead with goals? But they have lots of really important lessons that they've left to us. For those of you working with the Honor Study topic, legacies, if you will, that they've left for us. So we have Unit 2 is about leading by serving, becoming a servant leader, why, what that is, why that's important. Unit 3, understanding ethical leadership. Now there's a unit for today's world that we need. I guess we always need that no matter when it is. But that one is an important one as well. Articulating a vision. You know, as Phi Theta Kappa leaders, as community college students, it's really important to be able to articulate your vision and to do it quickly often. You may only have a couple of minutes to do that. Johanna mentioned that, you know, most of us have to watch the clock. If we're given 20 minutes, we have to zip in there. But very often you're only given, you know, 60 seconds, you know, riding the elevator up and you have a chance to talk to somebody. So we look at people have a variety of people who have had to articulate their vision, why it's important, how they did that. Unit 5 is building a team. Unit 6, leading with goals. Unit 7, making decisions, not always the easiest thing to do. So some people who have had to make some really remarkable decisions, how they did that, what their process was. There's some really interesting things to learn there. Unit 8, guiding through conflict. Again, maybe one for the ages and certainly one for today, and how people have managed to do that and to do it over time. We have some people who really have had to spend their lives guiding through conflict and how they've done that. So there's some really interesting stories and some interesting things that you can learn from their lives. And then Unit 9, realizing change. I mentioned doing things over time. Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Susan B. Anthony are the classic case in Unit 9. And they had to work for change, the women's right to vote, for more than 50 years, and neither of them ever got a chance to vote. So it's talking about sometimes how you're creating that legacy, how you're realizing change for other people that you may never actually get to live through. And so their story is interesting that way. And then Unit 10, you know, when you go through all of these things and you've got these leadership skills, really great leaders empower other people to be leaders. And so Unit 10 looks at that. What does that mean to empower other people? How do you do that? What are the legacies of some of the people who have done it? So those are the 10 units. And let's talk a little bit about what's in them. So in each unit, these are some more of our people who show up in the course, but in each unit, there's a classic case. I mentioned Angelina and Sarah Grimke. We have their letters to one another, but also to Angelina's husband, Theodore Weld. And so you get a sense of their philosophies from reading their letters. The leadership profiles that John Lewis and John McCain, they're both leadership profiles in Unit 1, and you get a chance to look at their letters to the American people. So in every unit, there's a leadership profile. And then we have, this is really new for this curriculum, we have a series of TED Talks in every unit. And the TED Talks did a number of things. It allowed us to bring in a lot of leaders who really wouldn't necessarily have made it into a traditional text because they don't necessarily have the writings we would have used, but they've done these really wonderful TED Talks. They range from about 5 minutes. David Brooks, who's the guy with the glasses and gray hair on the screen, his is about 5 minutes, and he talks about whether you should live your resume or live your eulogy and why. We have to think about that as leaders. And then we have on the other side of the screen, Jane Goodall, who is communicating with a chimpanzee. She's fabulous. She has the longest TED Talk, and it's a little bit over 20 minutes. So they vary from 5 minutes to a little over 20 minutes, easily watchable. And we have transcripts for every single one of them, I think with one exception that was a regional TED Talk. So a variety of leaders, again, all of them. This is Shonda Rhimes is up there. So her year of saying yes to things she wouldn't normally say yes to. Karen Betty, who is on the bottom of the screen, she brought yoga and mindfulness classes to a prison in India, a job that she got, an assignment that she really didn't want. And it turned out to be a really great leadership opportunity for her. So her story's really interesting. Jessica Jackley on the top of the page across from Shonda Rhimes, she works with microlending, particularly in Africa, but in around the world. And it was a really early proponent of looking at Muhammad Yunus's ideas of microlending. And she talks about in the Empowering Others unit about working with love. You know, it might not be something you see a lot in leadership curriculums, but for her, that's really important. And then it's a little bit hard to see him because he's in one of his community gardens, but Ron Findlay, who is known as the Los Angeles Gorilla Gardener, talks about why he's developed community gardens, why he develops them everywhere. You notice he's sitting on a curb. And so he really has grown these gardens and why that matters when you're really working with other people and leading other people. And then right beneath Jane Goodall is Cheryl Wudun. And her presentation is all about the plight of women in the world, particularly in a global perspective, not so much Western, but in other parts of the world. And so it's a really interesting TED Talk about, you know, why women's rights are human rights and why that matters. So the TED Talks have been really, really, really big for this curriculum. And we're really appreciative that TED Talks are open sources for nonprofit organizations and for colleges, which is great. So also in each unit, there's a leadership journal, there's a discussion board with a prompt, and there's a quiz in each unit. Yay, quizzes! But it's one way you get to know whether you know what lessons you've learned, and it's the way you really work toward the badges. And so they're not long, but they're really to give you a sense of reviewing for the material in the unit. And then some units also have some additional readings. We have, for example, the poem, The Road Not Taken, Robert Frost. It's obviously a famous poem, often misinterpreted. So there's an opportunity to listen to it, to read some criticism of it, criticism in the sense of understanding the poem and why it matters to leaders and what it's saying. There are podcasts in a couple of the units as well. Those are a little longer than the TED Talks. They tend to be an hour long, but some really interesting discussions about leadership are there. And then we have some exercises. I know a lot of you in the Texas region probably have done value sort, for example, which is in unit one, really, really powerful for understanding and developing a leadership philosophy. But we have in ethical leadership, whom to choose, and we have some other exercises that are a lot of fun to do, but they also have meaning within the units of the curriculum. And we're excited about that. So you will see these things as the organizational strategies for each of the units. So you'll know what to expect. Again, with unit one, you have to go all the way through the unit and do every single piece of it. With the other units, you can pick and choose what you'd like to read, what you'd like to watch, do the quizzes so you get your badges, but you get to choose other than that. I guess you get to choose whether you do the quizzes too, but you want those badges. They're pretty cool. All right, so I want to say thank you to Texas. I know that both Joe and I are here to answer questions. And I think I probably, let me see if I covered up my email. Here you go. If you have questions, you know, that we answer today, that's great. But if you have questions later and you're interested, please feel free to email me. That is true for advisors too. I noticed that there are several advisors. One of the things we have for chapter advisors that if you're not a certified faculty member, someone who is a faculty or staff member or an administrator who would like to teach the curriculum formally, teach it either for credit or non-credit, you can get certified by us. We have one session, in-person session scheduled for July, knock on wood, for Seattle, Washington, July 15th through 17th. But we will also have two or three additional virtual certification sessions this year. They were really successful last year, and the price point is a little bit easier on the pocketbook. So if you're interested, let me know, and I can share information with you about those. So thank you, Mary. And if people have questions for me and for Joe, I think we are happy to answer those.
Absolutely. If you have questions, please go ahead and drop them in the chat. A couple of things that I just want to say, I'll say speaking directly to advisors. When I did my certification to teach the leadership development studies, it's some of the best professional development I've ever had. And so I just can't emphasize enough how wonderful it is. So if you get that opportunity, please take advantage of it. You will not regret it. Even if you're not teaching it, just your own personal development, right? And that professional development is really valuable. So I encourage you to do that. To students, I will say, you've paid for your membership. And so what you should do then is take advantage of every opportunity you have from your membership. And a lot of that is your programming. And one of the great things about Phi Theta Kappa is you pay the one-time fee, right? You're not paying this annually. And you have access to all of these benefits forever. And so Phi Theta Kappa continues to develop more and more robust programming. And so you can keep taking advantage of these things long after you leave the community college. They started out with just competitive edge, and now you've seen how it's grown in a very short time, what these online curriculum offerings are. And so I really encourage you to get in there. I know you're busy, and I understand that, but that's the beauty of it. It's self-paced. So you can make it work around your schedule, do a little bit here and a little bit there. But take advantage of it, because you paid for your membership. So now reap all the benefits from it. It's really very valuable. I feel like a cheerleader. I should get some pom-poms. Does anyone have any questions about any of the edges or about the leadership development? Like class. No?
Yeah, I see Alicia posted that she's glad there are transcripts for accessibility. The other thing Reagan Chastain, who's our curriculum developer, did for us when we put everything online is that everything's organized into books for the leadership program, and you can actually print a lot of those things. So if you're not somebody who wants to read online, I know sometimes I really, especially when I'm editing, want to print something out and take a look at it, but you can do that. So we have paid attention to accessibility. We used a fairly early model of Moodle. So we will eventually move to a more advanced Moodle, and be able to do more, but we have paid attention to it. So thank you for noticing that, Amber.
Yeah, absolutely. It's just amazing, because we're now in the third kind of iteration of competitive edge, right? And seeing where it started and where we are, and then with the new curricular offerings, it's fantastic. The robustness of the programs, and then of course what Reagan has done in the delivery of those has just been fantastic.
I have a question that went straight to me, but someone asked if you have to take everything in order, or can you go through and pick up what you want to take? I'm glad you asked that, because I meant to mention that. But with the edges, you can pick and choose, like if you already know that what your career path is, for example, in employment ed, you can skip that first module. You can quiz, like Susan said, to get your badge, but you can skip through that and move to the next module. You can take the last module first, you can take the middle module, it doesn't matter. The content in the modules you have to take in order, but the modules themselves, if you feel like I already kind of know that, I don't need that, you can absolutely skip it and jump to the next module. So it's a great question. Thank you for asking.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can go back to it. It doesn't go away.
Yeah.
Right? You can go back and do it again. So it's good. It's good stuff. I love it. I said in the chat earlier, I'm the number one fan. Like, I think all the edges are great. Don't get me wrong. But like, I'm the number one fan of the new competitive edge. Like, I love it so much. I say this all the time. When I went through it, it was fantastic. I love every bit of it. You'd think I'm a paid sponsor. That's a joke for those who don't know. I don't get paid. All right. Any other questions? I don't think we have. Yes, definitely, Alicia. Definitely check it out. It really is very well done. I loved it. I like the section on time management. It's a thing I just really love the most. Oh, see, my cheerleading worked. I love it. Yes. I knew it would pay off one day. All right, if you think of any questions, I know that Ms. Edwards and Dr. Williams are happy to answer questions at any time that you have those, just email them. They are here to help you to take advantage of all of this wonderful programming as well. And thank you so much for presenting this workshop. We really appreciate it. We were sponsoring it here in Texas, but it was for everybody. We are going to put the recording of this up on the Texas Region YouTube channel. And I will post on our social media channels when that's available so that you can go watch it again if there's something you want clarity on, or you can share with other members in your chapter. But thank you again so much for presenting this, and thank you everyone for being here. We really appreciate it.